Good morning. Who's this?
Oh, it's Ricky Gervais. I don't usually listen. You know that. I'm not a fan. I'm not usually up at this time. I'm jet lagged. I've just got back from America, and I've had about 8 to 10 emails from really those weird eccentric people who live with cats, who know I'm an animal lover, saying we could win £20,000 if you win Christian O'Connell. Well, one, right, if I wanted £20,000, I'd put my hand in my pocket. I just reached down now, and I'm in my pyjamas. That's what you're dealing with, right? Seriously, if I wanted to speak to Christian O'Connell, I'd have kept in touch with him when I used to work with him at XFM. Okay? So, God. What do I have to do? Is this it? Have I won £20,000 yet?
Well, you know, I'm sorry to hear that it's such a sour note that you're calling us, because Melvin Hayes was not like this, Ricky.
Well, I'm more like Don Estelle. another cracking cultural reference for anyone over 82.
Well, they'll all be typing all these names, Don Estelle
exactly,
and Melvin Hayes, into Google today.
Lovely boy.
Surely one of TV's worst catchphrases, that. You know, there hasn't, you know, Shut That Door, I thought, was a pretty lazy one, but Lovely Boy was just such a weird one.
Shut That Door's good. Lovely Boy. Yeah, I've had a few. Largy Dark and a Graham. That was another one. Spread off our mum. Oh, dear. And, of course, all the racism. How can we forget that? All the lovely racism.
Well,
it wasn't that racist, because people who were, was obviously they were the butt of the joke. The stupid Brits over there were the butt of the joke, and the Asian guy was meant to be slightly empowered and in charge. I still think it's slightly outdated.
Put it this way, Ricky. When have you ever seen that repeated on a TV channel? That show is never repeated like that. Those UK TV channels.
The fact that the guy who played one of the Indian fellows was actually a white bloke.
That's right.
With a blacked up with a turban on. I mean, that probably doesn't help its cause much these days.
So listen, Ricky, why weren't you at the Oscars yesterday then?
I wasn't invited.
What? I thought you could just, you know, turn up with these things. You know, you hosted the Golden Globes.
I wasn't there, and I'd done the Golden Globes. You probably lay out your wares and they'd probably get a bit huffy. I sent a text yesterday to Steve Martin saying, good luck at the Globes, you and Alec could be brilliant. PS, let me know if you need any Holocaust material, right? And it's true. And he sent back a text. And good luck at the Globes. I can't wait to watch.
Well, listen, Ricky, thank you very much for being bothered to give us a call.
Yeah.
And, listen...
It's for the animals or the kids or whatever it's for.
It's for the cats.
It's for the cats. And, can I split it if I win? There's a few charities.
Oh, you tightwad. You've got to split it.
Well, you're the tightwad. You're giving out the fixed amount, so I'm going to have to split it amongst lots of charities.
Okay, so what are your charities that you're going to be sort of...
I'll do Wildlife Aid, the Mayhew Animal Centre, Moonbears, this charity that go and save, like, bears that are being mistreated and stuff. I just do those three.
I love this. You know, look, it's a big, dangerous, frightening world out there, Ricky. And
yeah.
You know, you say I'm calling in all these weirdo people that live with cats and stuff like that. You know, you've just named three animal charities. Are you going to be one of these millionaires that when you pass away, people go, "Oh my God, they've left it to some cat house."
Definitely. Yeah. I don't want to leave it to people, do they? People have got to work hard. I hate that. Why would I give it to anyone? I've worked hard for my money, I'll have you know. Yeah. At the moment now, I'm sitting in the garden where I've buried it and I've got a gun. I want to take my money, I tell you.
No, listen, Ricky, everyone that calls in, we're asking them, if you were to get elected come May to number 10, what would be the very first thing you do? I'm probably going to regret asking this live on national radio.
Okay.
But Ricky, what would it be for you?
Well, I suppose serious answer would be something like stopping all animal cruelty, particularly those inbreds who still go hunting when they're not meant to. I like to smack them in the mouth.
And then the answer you really want to say?
Well, I asked Kyle this once on one of our audiobooks, and he thought for ages. Come on, Kyle, you can do anything. You're Prime Minister today, anything. And it was torturous. He's going, and I went, come on. He went, oh, I banned traffic lights. Why did you ban traffic lights? So the day was just honking and crashing. I don't know. Stop brainwashing people with religion from the age of three. I don't know.
I know.
I'd reinstate traffic lights. It's chaos out there.
There you go. Perfect. Brilliant. Hey, listen, Ricky, when's Cemetery Junction out this year?
14th of April. Thanks for asking. I've got a free plug. I've saved the animals and I've got a free plug.
Hey.
You know, I call you every day.
There you go. Hey, Parkinson might not be around, but I'm still here for you, Ricky. Okay. I didn't realise it was next month. That's really soon. Fantastic. Are you happy with it?
Yeah, I think it's the best thing you've done. But you're meant to. I suppose you should think everything's the best thing you've done. You'll be the judge of that. In fact, that'll be good. Let's get rid of all the other critics, because they all contradict each other. So you're the only critic in Britain. Then we'd get some sort of parity. Then we could calibrate. Do you know what I mean? It's like at school when one teacher gave everyone 10 out of 10, even the divs, it meant nothing. And then other teachers gave everyone like 4 out of 10. So if we have one, you are the critic. You are this country's critic.
What, me?
Now, yeah, you.
But what if I go to see it, Ricky, and my review is I preferred Big Mama's House 2?
Well, you certainly will, because everything's personal to everyone. At least you'll give us a definitive score that we can then judge everything else on.
Okay, fair enough. Well, you know, I mean, if it's no Miss Congeniality, Ricky, I will let you know, all right?
He's an Oscar winner now, so I think you should treat her with more respect.
You're quite right. I'm so sorry there. You're quite right, yeah, Ricky, to pull me up there.
Well, listen, can happen. Right.
Thank you very much for giving us a call, and hopefully we see you soon, Ricky, okay?
I need that money in cash, and give it to me, not the animals, okay?
Okay.
I'll make sure
I get it. Yeah. Those poor old moon bears. Yeah, see you later, mate. Bye.
See you later,
mate.
Bye.
Wow. Outstanding. Absolutely.
I had it all.